hole, which underwent lots of small modifications. But the main idea is that it has to maintain the distributed connection state between the server and the client, which means the reservation of certain data structures at both ends of the connection. And by doing so, the system is able to reliably transfer data with a control rate of this transfer, which it tends to match the current network situation. But the drawbacks of the whole thing is that, first of all, it does limit the resources. Most importantly, it limits the resources of the server, because for each connection, the server has to maintain the state information related to it. It would be not that bad even if we had to reserve resources only at the client side, but the server side, the resource reservation leads to the following problems. First of all, the server can support only a limited amount of connections, which means a limited amount of clients. And the server is vulnerable to denial of service attacks, because each packet which indicates the start of connection makes the server to reserve the certain amount of resources for it, which may be just unused, and therefore the server will not be able to open new connections for new clients. So, having all those problems of TCP protocol, there were several attempts to create stateless but reliable transfer protocol for IP networks. And we selected perhaps the best development in this area, which was made by researchers at Cornell University in 2005. They proposed the protocol called Trickles. The main idea is that all of the connection state information is moved to the client. So you don't have to remember anything. It only performs some simple calculations in order to keep the rate control of the data transfer. Trickles protocol uses the same TCP segments, but with modifications which are allowed by RFCs. So all the data transfer in Trickles is being driven by the client. It happens by client requests. The client issues a request to fetch some data from the server, and this elemental request and response traversing the network is called Trickle. At the same time, there may be several, Trickles living on the network. And they all live independent lives on the network, and only the client actually synchronizes between them and keeps track of what is going on. When we come to the transmission control, the authors of Trickles, in fact, made an attempt to mimic the behavior of TCP protocol, TCP arena, as closely as possible. That is, the procedure has all the standard stages of TCP protocol, with slow start congestion avoidance, retransmit timeout, and fast recovery. In fact, the slow start and congestion avoidance is performed by the server, which has to increase or keep the same amount of trickle strands in the network, and it also provides the rate control parameters, which are sent back between the client and the server, and which actually guides the way the client requests data for the new transmissions, and thus manages the connection through. Well, since I said the main idea of trickle transmission control is mimicking the behavior of standard TCP, makes it quite close from the network point of view to the TCP behavior, but at the same time gives quite a lot of advantages like response. First of all, the main advantage is that the server can be replicated. The client can be working with several copies of the server, because from the client point of view, from the connection point of view, they are all identical. The server being built of the need to keep all the connection information.
Logic and to open for protocol.
allowing the switch to send packets, for example, old sequence numbers to one port and even sequence number to another port, which is a proposition. The other idea, which is much more easy to realize, is introducing a border device at the border of the network, which would be splitting the, for example, two flows out of one flow or even more, in order to for the network to handle them differently by a standard width. And this border device would be close contact to these are the two ideas of the following research and the following direction of thoughts. This is basically it. Thank you for your attention and welcome your questions. Just a light.
So thank you for an interesting talk. Yeah, and first, yes, okay. Thank you. It's pretty cool.